Hello everyone, let's talk about how to trigger a React.js application with Keyclock. As the prerequisites, you should have running Keyclock server. If you have some knowledge about the OpenID Connect protocol, that will be an added advantage, but that knowledge is not mandatory. Okay, let's begin. In order to connect any application with Keyclock, we need to use one of the below protocols. It should be OpenID Connect or SAML. Those are the single sign-on protocols supported by Keyclock. For this integration, we are using OpenID Connect protocol. If you have enough knowledge about OpenID Connect, you will understand certain things very easily. But as I mentioned earlier, OpenID Connect knowledge is not mandatory for this task. You just have to follow me. First, I will start from the Keyclock application side. In order to connect an application with Keyclock, we need to create a client in Keyclock to represent that application. You can see here, I'm in the admin console now. To create a client, I need to visit the clients page. Here you can see all the existing clients. I'm going to create a new client by clicking on the Create Client button. I brought the client ID as React Client. You need to make sure the client type is OpenID Connect. And I scroll down and click Next button. Here I keep the standard flow enabled and disable the rest of the checkboxes. Again I click Next. Here I need to provide a valid redirect URI and a valid web origin. Redirect URI is used to redirect the user to the application after successful login. Here I put any URL starts with localhost port 3000 because my React application is running on that port. For the web origin section, again I put localhost 3000. If the web origin is not properly added, you will get cross-origin resource sharing related problems when you try to authenticate. Here I save the client. Now the client is created properly. I need to do just one thing here to make this setup more secure. I'm going to enable PIXI method for additional security. PIXI stands for Proof Key for Code Exchange. I will explain about that later in a separate video. For the moment, we just need to do is go into the advanced section. Scroll down until we find the Proof Key for Code Exchange code challenge method. Here I set that value as S256. If you are not familiar with PIXI protocol, you don't need to worry about that, or you can learn that from internet. Here I save the client configurations. Now client configurations are totally complete. Now I'm going to create a new user as well. Here I go to the users section, click add user. Here I brought the username as test. Click create button and I need to provide a password as well. Here I go to the credentials section and set password. Again I set the password as test. I disable the temporary switch and save. Right now the password is created for this test user. In addition to that, I am going to add a role to this user as well. Here I go to the roles tab and here I am going to assign a role. I provide the Realm admin role to this particular user. Here I click on the checkbox related to admin and click assign. Okay, now we have a user. Username is test. And we have already assigned a password for the user and also we have assigned a role as well. Now we are all good with Keyclock server level configurations. Now I'm going to the React application. Okay, here you can see I have opened my React.js application code in my code editor. I have already done all the required configurations and I will take you through all the important stuff of this application. So I will start from the package.json file. Here we have added the Keyclock.js dependency and the version is 20.0.3. That value should be equal to the server versions of the key clock. In addition to that, I have added Axios HTTP library in order to send an HTTP request and show how this works. In addition to that, I have added some prime libraries for UI enhancements. So those are the only libraries I have added here. Let me take you through the app.js file. Now I'm in the app.js file. I have done all the coding in that file to make it easier for you to understand the code. But once you learned what I have done, you can modularize the code as you prefer. Here I have initialized a JSON including the keyclock configuration details. URL attribute has the keyclock server's URL. Realm is set to master since we are using the default master realm. Client ID is set to the name of the client I created few minutes back. With these init options, keyclock client instance is created and I have given the name KC for the keyclock client. Hereafter, this instance will do all the communication with the keyclock server. After creating the keyclock client, we need to initialize the instance with the set of parameters by calling the init function. We need to provide an object containing certain attributes for this init function. The first attribute I have set here is onLoad. As valid options for onLoad, we can provide login required or check SSO values. Here I have provided the login required option. With that option, this React application is accessible only for successfully authenticated users. Otherwise, the user will be always redirected to the keyclock login page when she tries to access this React application. With the check SSO option, the application will be accessible for unauthenticated users as well. In that scenario, React application will silently check whether the user has an active session or not. There's another property named checkLoginIframe. By default, the adapter creates a hidden iframe that is used to detect if a single signout has occurred, because the user might have already logged out from a system in a separate browser tab. If the user has already signed out from a different browser tab, this React application will learn that with this option enabled. Check keyclock JavaScript adapter documentation for more information if you like to learn more on that. Proof key for code exchange method is set to S256, which would be the same as the value we set in the keyclock server client configuration section. Those are the only options that I have added to initialize this React keyclock client. If you want to know about more options, check that keyclock documentation. I have added the link in the description area. Once the int method is called, it will return a JavaScript promise object. Based on the results of that promise, we can determine whether the user is authenticated or not. If the user is authenticated, I have set some operations to be executed. I have set up to log certain information to the browser console for debug purpose. Make sure to disable them if you are using the setup in a production environment. There's another special thing I need to mention here. Upon successful authentication, within the callback itself, you can set the access token in your HTTP client. So any request you send using your HTTP client will include the access token as a bearer token. So this is that particular implementation. So with this line, your HTTP client will contain this access token as a bearer token. Yeah, basically here what I have done is set in a new HTTP header named authorization. I have set the access token as a bearer token. In addition to that, I have added another event handler to capture the token expired events and log an event to the browser console. Here we are only logging that information to the browser console. Otherwise, we can alert the user about the session expiry as well using the same event handler. Those are the things I have added in the authentication callback. Let me take you through the user interface of the application. This is just the header of the application. Here I have added a set of buttons to show some important functions of the keyclock client SDK. First button is used to know whether the user is authenticated or not. If the user is authenticated, the kc.authenticated attribute will be true. Second button is used to initiate a login. If you have set check SSO value instead of login required for the onLoad argument, this button is necessary to initiate a login. With the login required option, users should be authenticated to access the application. Therefore, this button is no longer needed with that option. Otherwise, it will directly call this kc.login function and it will initiate the login. This button locks the access token by getting it from the kc.token attribute. And the next button shows the passed access token by using the kc.token passed attribute. And this button is used to check whether the access token is expired. Here I pass an argument to the function isTokenExpired. Here I am passing the number 5. Therefore, isTokenExpired function will return true if the token is already expired or it will be expired within next 5 seconds. Therefore, it is easier to check with that particular argument whether the token is expired or not within few seconds or few minutes ahead. And this button is used to update the token. Here also I am passing an argument. If the access token is going to be expired within next 10 seconds, it will be refreshed. Otherwise, the update request will be ignored. This button is used to send an HTTP request to the backend. It is used to demonstrate the access token is appended as a bearer token to each backend call executed by the HTTP client. And this is the logout button, which is used to log out from the application by calling kc.logout. In addition to that, we need to provide a redirect URI as well. This should be a valid redirect URI, and this URL is already set in the KeyClock client configurations. We did that when we were configuring the client in KeyClock server. Last two buttons are used to check whether any realm role or client role is assigned to this user by calling kc.hashRealmRole and kc.hashResourceRole functions. So that's all with the code. Let's move on to the demo. My KeyClock server is already running. I just started the React application as well. These are the commands to start both the KeyClock server and the React application in case you are new to them. I just switched to my web browser and here I type http localhost 3000, which is the default URL of the React application, and I press enter. With that, I was successfully redirected to the KeyClock login page because I have set the onNode value as login required. Therefore, I cannot access the application without having a valid session. Here I provide the credentials of the user I created. Username and password both are test. Test and password is also test. I click sign in. Okay, I was successfully redirected to the React application upon the successful authentication. Let's check each button one by one. Click on the first button, is authenticated, we are authenticated and that value is true. There's no impact from the login button since I have successfully authenticated already. Let's check the access token by clicking on show access token button. Let's check the passed access token as well. It contains all the details of the complete JWT token. Let's check whether the token is expired or not. Okay, it is not expired. Okay, we can update the access token if it is about to expire. Token refresh did not happen because it is not going to expire within next 10 seconds. Okay, let's send an HTTP request to the backend and check whether it works. Here I open the network tab of the browser. Okay, I just went to the network tab. And here I click send HTTP request button. I have configured the code to send an HTTP request to this URL, which is mockbean.com/request. I just click the send button. Okay, here the request is sent. Let's check the request header. Okay, here we have the response header and this is the request header. And request header contains the access token as a bearer token. We can conclude that access token is added properly. Right, we are done with that part. Before clicking on the logout button, I would like to test the other two buttons, has realm role admin and has client role test. Okay, so check whether this user has the realm role admin. Yes, it is set to true because we have already assigned the admin role to this particular user. Okay, let's check whether this user has client role name test. Okay, which is false because we did not assign any client role to this particular user. Okay, all the buttons are working properly and let's check whether logout works. Upon logout, again we were successfully redirected to the KeyClock login page. So logout is also working successfully. So that concludes, all the functionalities are successfully working. And with that, we come to the end of this video. If you have any question, please put them as a comment. See you in the next video. Thank you very much.